स्टूडेंट, इन टुडेज लेक्चर आई विल टेल यू अबाउट डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ ब्रेन। इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैव शोन यू हाउ टू ड्रॉ ए वेल लेबल्ड डायग्राम ऑफ लॉन्गिट्यूडनल सेक्शन ऑफ ब्रेन, बट हेयर नाउ वी विल स्टडी अबाउट डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ ब्रेन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, आवर ब्रेन इज डिवाइडेड इंटू थ्री पार्ट्स। First part is forebrain. In forebrain, there are two further divisions. First division is telencer helen. And the second division is diencephalon. Forebrain is divided into telencephalon and diencephalon. Forebrain is also called prosencephalon. Now here, telencephalon contain two cerebral hemispheres. Whereas diencephalon part is further divided into pineal gland, thalamus, the upper part of thalamus, epithalamus, and lower part of thalamus, hypothalamus. Pituitary gland. Now here we are talking about the first part of the brain, that is forebrain. Forebrain is also called prosencephalon. Forebrain is divided into telencephalon and diencephalon. Telencephalon contain cerebral hemispheres. Our cerebrum is divided into two equal halves, and the two equal halves, and each half contain four lobes. Here, diencephalon contain parts of brain like pineal gland, thalamus, epithalamus, hypothalamus and pituitary gland. Now we will study about middle part of the brain, that is midbrain or mesencephalon. I am going to rub this. Telencephalon contain two cerebral hemispheres, and diencephalon contain parts of brain like pineal gland, thalamus, epithalamus, hypothalamus, and pituitary gland. Now the second part of brain is midbrain. Midbrain is also called mesencephalon. Mesencephalon. Now, the parts of brain which come under mid brain are cerebral aqueduct. Cerebral aqueduct cerebral pedunculus substantia nigra tegmentum Z nucleus and corpora quadrigemina. Corpora quadrigemina. Now, these are the parts of brain which come under midbrain. Midbrain is also known as mesenchymal cerebellum. Okay, now I am going to rub this mid part portion of brain. Midbrain contain cerebral pedunculus, substantia nigra. Substantia nigra region is rich in dopaminergic neuron, and if a person suffer from Parkinson's disease, then what happens? Dopaminergic neurons in this region gets degenerated. Tegmentum, Z nucleus, and then at the last corpora quadrigemina. You have to learn these parts of brain, that is midbrain, which contain tegmentum, Z nucleus, corpora quadrigemina, Z nucleus, and substantia nigra. Now we will study about the last part, that is hindbrain. Hindbrain is also called Rubensabhelan. Hindbrain is also called Rubensabhelan, and hindbrain is divided into two parts. Hindbrain, which is called Rubensabhelan, is further divided into two parts. The first part is metencephalon, and the second part is myelencephalon. Metencephalon. Metencephalon contains two parts of brain. First part is cerebellum, and second part is pons velluli. Cerebellum controls the movement of our body. It maintains the body coordination with muscles. This is myelencephalon. Myelencephalon contain medulla oblongata. Medulla oblongata, it contain respiratory center, and it also control coughing, sneezing, etc. Now this is the third part of human brain. This is hindbrain, and it is also known as Rubensabhelan. Hindbrain is divided into metencephalon and myelencephalon. Mittens of Helen contain cerebellum and pons vesuli, whereas myelins of Helen contain medulla oblongata. These are the parts of brain. Now I will teach you how to draw. Now I will show you different parts of brain with the help of diagram. First of all, you will draw part of Diane's of Helen. This is thalamus. The part above thalamus is called epithalamus. The part below thalamus is called hypothalamus. Now here from the epithalamus, here comes pineal gland. This is pineal gland, and here comes habeneural nuclei. This part comes under, these parts of brain comes under Diane's of Helen. I have told you previously that first part of brain, that is forebrain, also known as Prosens of Helen, is divided into two parts. First part is Telens of Helen, which contain cerebral hemispheres, and the second part is Diane's of Helen, which contain parts like thalamus, upper part of thalamus, epithalamus, lower part of thalamus, hypothalamus, and pineal gland. Now, see carefully, in order to make the diagram of brain, from here at the tip of pineal gland, we will try to make cerebrum, that is part of Telens of Helen. This is one cerebral hemisphere. This is one cerebral hemisphere. Our cerebrum, which is a part of forebrain, is divided into two equal cerebral hemispheres, right cerebral hemisphere and left cerebral hemisphere. Now, this is the longitudinal section of brain. Therefore, only one cerebral hemisphere is visible here. Each cerebral hemisphere is made up of four lobes. Each cerebral hemisphere contains four lobes. Therefore, two halves of cerebral hemisphere contain eight lobes. Now here, in one cerebral hemisphere, four lobes are present. This lobe is temporal lobe. Temporal lobe is near to our nose and ear. Therefore, temporal lobe contains olfactory area and auditory area. Olfactory area help our brain to understand what our ear hear, and olfactory area help our brain to understand the smell, which is sensed by Cnidarian membrane. Now here, above temporal lobe, frontal lobe is present. Frontal lobe contain Broca speech area, which help us to speak, and primary cortex area. Now here above frontal lobe in the middle is present parietal lobe. Parietal lobe contain sensory cortex and gustatory area. Gustatory area provide the sensation of taste from our tongue to the brain. Gustatory area is present over here. Now here, this lobe is called present at the back. This lobe of cerebral hemisphere is called occipital lobe. Occipital lobe contain visual area. Okay. Now temporal lobe contain. Temporal lobe contain. Auditory area. And olfactory. Auditory area help us to understand what our ear hear, and olfactory area which help our brain to understand what our nose smell. Now in the frontal lobe is present Broca speech area. Broca area. It helps us to speak what we think. Broca speech area is present in the frontal lobe. And in the frontal lobe, primary motor cortex area is also present. Primary motor cortex area is also present in the frontal lobe. Now here in the parietal lobe, sensory cortex area is present. Primary sensory cortex and gustatory area is present in the parietal lobe of the cerebral hemisphere, and this gustatory area help our brain to understand what is the taste of our food. Gustatory area. Occipital lobe of the cerebral hemisphere contain visual area. We know an inverted image is formed on our retina, and this information is being interpreted by the visual area, and we see upright image of the object. Now this is the here it is the pineal gland. Pineal gland is an important neuroendocrine gland, and pineal gland release melatonin, which help us to understand the day and night cycle. Then pineal gland ka hormone, you have to learn it. It is melatonin. This is epithalamus, thalamus, hypothalamus. Now here, we have to complete our diagram of brain. Now you see this skull. What we will do, we will bend it over here, and here comes out optic chiasma. Then here below the hypothalamus, I have told you that below the hypothalamus, here comes pituitary gland, and there is a stalk which connect the pituitary gland with the hypothalamus. This stalk is known as infundibulum. This is infundibulum, this is hypothalamus, and this is
pituitary gland. This is pituitary gland. Now here, we'll draw it like this. Then here comes the pons. And our brain continues into the vertebral column region. This is pons velluli. This is medulla oblongata. This is a small brain, it is called cerebellum. This is cerebellum, and this region, the ventricle present in this region of the brain is called fourth ventricle. Now ventricle are the chambers which are present inside the brain. For example, below each cerebral hemisphere, one lateral ventricle is present. Here, in this region of diencephalon, third ventricle is present. And here, in this region, which contains metencephalon and myelencephalon, fourth ventricle region is present. Okay? Ventricle are the chamber inside the brain. The wall of the ventricle is made up of a set of capillaries called choroid plexus, which release cerebrospinal fluid inside the ventricle, and this cerebrospinal fluid provide nutrients, glucose, to our neurons and neuroglial cell. Neurons and neuroglial cell are responsible for the basic functioning of brain. We know that the basic functional and structural unit of central nervous system is neuron, and central nervous system contain two important organs. The first organ is brain and the other organ is spinal cord. Now here, this is the complete longitudinal section of brain. This is the cerebrum. This is the not cerebrum. Cerebrum is made up of two equal halves of cerebral hemispheres. Means two cerebral hemispheres make one cerebrum. It is only one cerebral hemisphere. Now here I am going to draw corpus callosum. Here is the corpus callosum. You can see here. This is corpus callosum. Corpus callosum is a nerve band which joins two cerebral hemispheres together. Two cerebral hemispheres join with the help of corpus callosum and make a complete cerebrum. The surface of the cerebrum is highly convoluted and it is made up of gyri and sulci. Now this is, here I will show you, this is the fourth ventricle. Here, this is the fourth ventricle region. This is the fourth ventricle. Here is the third ventricle. And below the each cerebral hemisphere comes the lateral ventricle. This is optic chiasma. This is the diagram of brain, and I hope you can draw this diagram after observing this.